Now, with the fear of more lockdowns looming, the idea of throwing it all in, getting a motorhome, packing in the family, taking life on the road, well, for some, not me, it's never been so tempting.
Look, it's certainly a dream for many of you, but it turns out making that dream become a reality is rife with complications. Caitlin explains.
So we started out with a tent, which then moved into a 1970s caravan, which then moved into an imported caravan.
That is happiness. But still, this party of six was a squeeze. They needed to think bigger. Say kia ora to Tina the bus, the perfect fit for the Turner whānau.
We love our bus and we love what it gives to our kids and our family.
Including family time converting it from a bus to a motorhome.
So we had the kids out there with screwdrivers undoing screws and bolts and tried to get them involved in it as much as we could.
For the basic whānau, new wheels represented change in pace on and off the road.
I thought, oh well, let's just get rid of everything, buy a bus and we'll go on the road.
First though, making it homeworthy.
We've spent so long building this bus, right down to hand sewing my curtains.
Going from a 6-bedroom house into an 11-metre bus with no bedrooms and kids that grow up with, you know, these big lavish spaces to just fill with clothing and toys.
So we gave the kids a box each. Man, did they moan about it, but they managed and now they love it.
Quality family time. Well, as long as the bus isn't moving.
Because they cannot drive legally in the bus with me.
Since 2003, motorhomes, or vehicles converted into motorhomes, must be fitted with seatbelts. And the total number of seatbelts has to match the number of beds. That means 8 belts to strap the basics in safely. The problem is, no one can do the work.
Spent a lot of time trying to find someone who would do the seat belts.
They needed someone to install the belts and another to certify them. That's a job for a heavy vehicle engineer.
I'm just inquiring about getting some seat belts.
There are currently 125 heavy vehicle specialists in New Zealand, but just 69 are qualified to certify seat belts. The basics say they've crossed off nearly every one.
No problem, thank you.
The second you mention seatbelts, they can't get off the phone fast enough.
It's the same for the Turners.
Unfortunately, we couldn't find any certifiers locally or engineers that were willing to take on the work. We know people are waiting 6 months just to get drawings done.
And even we couldn't find a workshop that was doing a seatbelt installation. Most told us they'd given up on motorhome work because certifiers weren't available to sign off on it. Thankfully for the Turners, they finally got their belts in, though at a cost, and hold on to your seat.
All up, we were about $15,500 for the seat belts. The bus itself, we paid $11,000 for, so yes, the seat belts cost more than the actual bus.
Of course, these parents don't want to skimp on safety.
It just seems a little bit unfair that a week before we purchased the bus, it was being used for school children.
This bus used to take 35 kids to school each day, seated and standing. Only the bus driver wore a seatbelt. As soon as it was classed as a motorhome, it stopped being roadworthy.
So we want our kids to be safe, but it does seem like the standards are unusually high.
Heavy vehicle engineers aren't just looking at motorhomes, they work on commercial vehicles too, and there are a lot.
The increase in the number of commercial vehicles has meant more and more certificates required.
Adding to the workload is that the industry has been under a review after compliance problems. Waka Kotahi, the transport agency, told Fair Go it's been a difficult journey for all involved, but necessary to ensure the safety of heavy vehicles on our roads. Calvin was one of the original engineers appointed to do heavy vehicle work. He says these days they just don't have time to look at motorhomes.
The commercial vehicles need to be done so basically we keep the country moving. Because if they couldn't get their vehicles complied, then they're off the road.
If seat belts aren't the priority, what do people do? What option do they have?
There aren't really any other options at this stage. They just have to wait.
The transport agency says it's working to find solutions.
Waka Kotahi has publicly acknowledged that there is a shortage of heavy vehicle certifiers and is working closely with industry to address this.
It says we can expect to see changes on exactly who can certify seatbelts in the future. But it's too little too late for the basics.
Just had to list it for sale. It's going to be gutting.
While the turners say it's all about the long game.
Just be prepared and do your research. Find someone to do your seatbelts first. Don't leave that till last.
Because it's not so easy to make it.
Now, Caitlin, very determined woman, will keep on at Waka Kotahi NZTA about those changes as to who can certify the seatbelts. She's going to let you know.
Yes, a couple of other quick things too. Those seatbelt requirements are for all vehicles converted into motorhomes after October 2003, so older ones aren't required to have them, although it is, of course, strongly encouraged.
That makes very little sense. There could also be some movement in that baffling situation of seatbelts not being compulsory on school buses. It's a topic we've looked at on Fair Go. Of course, last month, a petition was presented to Parliament where it will be put before MPs so more information can be gathered and hopefully steps taken.